Sculpture in the world. There's another one called Genghis Khan in Mongolia, but that has a rider on top, so I think that doesn't count. So the Kelpies have been opened in 2014, so they're really only a couple of years old, but since then millions of people have come to visit, thousands of people along the motorway, so really quite quite far exceeded expectations. So here we are, we're a little bit closer, we'll get a different view of them, you know, left and right, head down and head up. When Andy Scott created them, he obviously had a particular idea. They look both very different. Different position of the heads, different expressions. And he wanted his visitors, us, to be intrigued to the point of being passionate about why they are so different, you know, in interpreting them, having our own ideas and looking at them. So I want to ask you today, what do you think? I usually ask this question, and I tell you as well what other people have said, but what do you think when you first see them? What does head down look like? What does head up look like? What's your impression?
Well, I think head down is coming stroke me.
Come and stroke me, head down.
I'm going to kill you. Yeah.
Head down is quite inviting. Come and stroke me, head up is sort of like, get off me, get away. Mm-hmm. This one's looking at you. Yes, that's what I said earlier about the steel plate. It's looking at us, straight at us at the moment. We can't really look at the eyes, looking into the sky. Yeah, a lot of people say this about head down. He's quite, you know, he's thinking, he's calm. He's gentle. Some people say he even looks noble, you know, quite a slim sort of nose. He's pulling a plough, yes. That's, you know, some people, especially with his ears flicked back, he looks like he's about to burst into some sort of energetic move, maybe pulling a plough, yes. And with the head up, again, different opinions. People say that he's angry, you know, it's fur going up. But then when the weather's nice, some people also think he's just neighing and being friendly and happy and just... Some people think he's rearing up. Children have said he's scared of the motorway and going, ah! And I once had a horsey person on my tour and she had a nice interpretation. She thought that head down is very cheeky and not nice and gentle at all because he's just bitten head up. It's like, ouch! So really nice. And I give you one last one which is completely different and that's why I like it. Once I had a doctor of philosophy on my tour, and he thought that the one with the head down should be called Plato, because all his theories are concerned with looking at the earth. And this one with the head up should be called Aristotle, because because all his theories are concerned with looking at the sky. So here we are. So everybody brings their own ideas to it, which is exactly how Andy Scott would have liked it. And when he created them, he obviously looked to the breed that was most commonly used to work alongside equine. And you, of course, know this breed, the Clydesdale horses, a true Scottish breed. And he looked for two particular muses, and they were working in Pollock Country Park, Glasgow City Council, giving people rides. And the one with the head down was modelled by a horse called Duke, and the one with the head up was modelled by a horse called Baron.
Baron.
And they both came during the opening. I've got a picture which I can hand around. So we've got Andy Scott in the middle, and then we've got Duke with the on the left side here, and then we've got Baron here with his head up. And Duke also left us a present, which you will be able to see when we get into his head later. And I'll just pass it around so you can have a look. Now, as I said, but when he started talking to people, and he's from Falkirk. I need to open it first. There we go. It's quite something. Mm-hmm. Come inside and have a look. So I think this is very fitting, and it's also a very popular selfie one spot where you can get the whole head in as well as yourself, if you're good at these things. I'm not. But yeah. So I think this is another really good view and another different side of Duke that you might miss otherwise, which I think is great. But apart from this,